Now let us start problems on first module. Today's class I'm going to solve a problem on principal stresses. Now here is the given problem. This a point in this member is subjected to three principal stresses. That is, it is subjected to three stresses. One is 140 MPa along the x-axis. So we will consider it as sigma x 140 MPa. Since it is tensile, the sign is positive, and it is also subjected to another stress 90 MPa in the y direction. So sigma y is equal to 90 MPa, and it is also subjected to shear stress. It is a biaxial stress along with the shear. So shear stress is given as 50 MPa. This is the shear stress. It is shown like this. So axial stress will be acting perpendicular to the member, whereas shear stress will be acting parallel to the member. Okay. So here is the shear stress 50 MPa. Okay. And we need to find the normal stress and tangent shear stress on this element, which is inclined at an angle of 30 degree. So given angle is 30 degree. So let us learn how to find the normal stress and shear stress on this inclined plane EF. Yep. Let me call this as EF. Okay. So normal stress on plane EF can be found by using the formula sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into cos 2 theta plus tau x y into sin 2 theta. This formula is available in your data handbook. You can use either old or new data handbook, both are available. If you use the old data handbook, the equation number is 2.30. For the users of new data handbook, equation number is 2.32. That is the second chapter, equation number 30. Or second chapter, equation number 32 for new data handbook. Okay. So here substitute the value of sigma x, sigma y, and theta tau xy. Sigma x, it is along the x-axis, we got it as 140 MPa, which is there already given in the problem. So substitute the value of sigma x. Next is sigma y. Sigma y is along the y-axis, it is 90 MPa. Substitute it. Next, similarly substitute sigma x and sigma y. Cos 2 theta, cos of 2 into theta. Theta is 30 degree. This inclination given is 30 degree. So give the theta value as 30. Plus tau xy is 50 into sin 2 theta. Sin 2 into theta is 30 degree. If you do the calculation, answer will be 170.8 newton per mm square. This is the normal stress on the inclined plane. On this inclined plane, the normal stress acting is 170.8 newton per mm square. Now, similarly, on the same plane, let us find the shear stress. Shear stress on the plane EF can be found using the formula tau theta is equal to minus of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 into sin 2 theta plus tau xy into cos 2 theta. Again, this formula is also available in your data handbook. If you are using old data handbook, it is 2.31. For new users, it is 2.33. That is, in data handbook, you have to open the second chapter. Equation number is 31. Okay. Now substitute the values of sigma x and sigma y. Sigma x is 140 MPa and sigma y is 90 MPa by 2 sin 2 into 30 plus tau xy is 50 MPa into cos 2 theta, 2 into 30. Okay. So if you go for calculation, the final answer is 3.35. The final answer comes to be 3.35 newton per mm square. Check whether it is positive or negative. Do the calculation. So here also you get it as positive, and here also it is positive. What is the meaning of this positive sign? What is the meaning of positive sign? Positive sign here indicates it is going to produce counterclockwise rotation. The stresses are going to produce counterclockwise rotation. Okay. This is how you can find the normal stress and shear stress on the inclined plane. Okay. In next class, let us learn how to find the principal stresses on this member. Okay. Thank you.